So if you have a female who has, let's say, a poor diet, she drinks these sugar-sweetened beverages, for example, or a mother who's got some sort of chronic stress that she's under for whatever mm-hmm. reason, maybe mm-hmm. she's a caregiver of a parent with Alzheimer's disease. And so so either of these cases, you know, before she gets pregnant, she's exposed to these types of bad stress.
Yeah.
Now, let's say during pregnancy, mm-hmm. she cuts out the sugar-sweetened beverages, mm-hmm. You know, does that impact the telomeres of the offspring, or is there something that goes on during pregnancy? Yeah, yeah.
So I love these questions, and we absolutely should know the answers, because what happens during pregnancy and how the aging clocks are set, the epigenetic clock, the telomere length, the immune system, how much it's primed for inflammation, those are so important at birth. Those are trajectories that have set up that baby for the rest of their life. These are lasting imprints. So we don't know. I'll tell you what we do know. So we do know that stress during pregnancy is associated with the shorter telomeres at birth in the cord blood. So that one has become...
What kind of stress during pregnancy?
So that one has been measured in a couple different ways. So I think the life events are the kind of easiest thing to measure rather than the feelings of stress. So bad things that happen, job loss, mourning, victimization, financial events. So when you add those up during pregnancy, they predict shorter telomeres, but also it's been studied in the year before birth, and that predicts shorter telomeres in cord blood. So here's what I think. I think your point about, is it before pregnancy and the health that they came into pregnancy with? I think that is so much of what's happening for women and men. So it is the health of sperm and the health of eggs in pre-pregnancy that is partly shaping the health through epigenetics. And so now that we know that there's, you know, important epigenetics the dad is passing on too, we've got to pay attention to the health of the mom and the dad before they conceive.
Yeah.
I mean, of course, throughout their life, but I think the health of sperm and eggs are critical before you get pregnant. And
it's a really important point that most people of reproductive age do not think about.
Yeah.
Particularly those that have unhealthy lifestyles,
right.
Because you know, it's one thing to kind of sort of give up on your own. You're like, well, whatever, I'm, you know, it's my life. But when you start to think about your unborn child, mm-hmm. I think people become a little more
motivated. Yeah. So you, with your immense knowledge on aging, what did you change when you got pregnant? Did you and your husband do anything differently?
Well, we've been really focused on good nutrition and good lifestyle for quite some time. Mm-hmm. But, you know, we certainly were very, you know, focused on making sure we're getting lots of micronutrients, getting enough protein, getting omega-3 mm-hmm. fatty acids. I mean, that was a big one.
Yeah.
Exercise, and definitely the stress, keeping the stress low, mm-hmm. you know.